Slugterra. Slugterra is a new computer-generated show made by Nerdcore, the same people behind the show Stormbox, and appears regularly on Disney XD. The show is about a kid named Eli Shane who one day ventures down to Slugterra, a surprisingly well-lit cave situated 100 miles underground. How on earth can it be that bright 100 miles underground? I've been underground! It looks more like this!
Mamma mia, mamma mia!
Mamma mia, let me go! Beelzebub has a devil put aside for me! For me! For me!
The thing is, Eli is the son of the former hero and lawman of Slugterra who performed the old disappearing dad routine several years ago while confronting a man named Dr. Black. Black is the owner of the Slugterran Express, a railway system linking all of Slugterra together. He uses his position to stand above the law and prefers to embarrass Eli rather than simply killing him, in order to prove that nobody in the Shane family can stand against him, thus bolstering his position. Fortunately, Eli is helped along by Burpee, his dad's powerful Infernus slug, Pronto, a rather stereotypical mole person tracker, Trixie, an independent reporter and slug expert, and Kord, a cave troll who is a whiz with technology. Together, they form a posse called the Shane Gang in an attempt to restore law and order to Slugterra. The core element of Slugterra is, of course, the slugs. No, not the kind you put into your shotgun, more the kind that devours your vegetable garden.
It's a pun!
The slugs that live in Slugterra have special properties that are triggered whenever they achieve a speed of 100 miles an hour. This unleashes a powerful new form that can wield various elemental abilities. These transformations make the slugs prized as armaments in the world of Slugterra, and are used by people called slingers, who participate in duels by firing slugs at one another. However, slugs are treated as little more than livestock in Slugterra, things to be used, traded, and sold rather than form an emotional bond to. One of the dilemmas facing Eli and the group is the growing evidence that slugs are actually highly intelligent, possibly even sapient, and that treating them like property is actually a questionable practice. The other problem is what Dr. Black has been up to since Eli's dad vanished. Dr. Black discovered a substance called dark water that causes a radical change in a slug when exposed to it, turning it into a vicious ghoul slug. Not only are ghoul slugs more powerful, dangerous, and unpredictable, the continued creation of ghoul slugs runs the risk of destroying Slugterra's ecosystem. This is why Eli and his friends are trying to resist the growing ghoul slug movement, which, in a world where slugs are seen as little more than ammunition, will require changing public opinion as well as putting a stop to Dr. Black's schemes. Not only that, but Slugterra is still a wild and unpredictable wilderness, meaning that Eli really has his hands full as the new Shane.
I cannot feel my legs!
That's because you're grabbing mine.
So yeah, boys action series to be sure, but Slugterra actually finds a lot of its core elements in the Western genre. I mean, think about it. A lawless wilderness filled with rogue gangs of gunslingers? A land where the train baron is king and times are tough? The wide open, unexplored wilderness? Eli having a last name that sounds like sheriff and wearing a gold star on his chest? Yeah, real subtle there. But that is something that helps set Slugterra apart from everything else. I mean, yeah, I've had questionable taste in cartoons on this show before, but I think Slugterra actually has something that makes it better than all of those. The characters are likable and their situation is sympathetic. Even Pronto gets his moment of glory every now and then. They just put out a DVD with the first 5 episodes on it for about $10. I'd say give it a look. And of course, there's the reason you're here. The toys. Made by Jack Specific, the toys released for Slugterra so far are all cross-compatible with each other. They also come with a code that unlocks additional content on the online game Battle for Slugterra, which plays kind of like a Mega Man game, and in the app Slug It Out, which is like Bejeweled combat mode. The Slugterra blasters are all basic dart blasters that fire darts with slug heads on them attached to a suction dart. The darts can also be fitted with a transforming cowling for use in a game. Each cowling depicts a different slug in their transformed state and has a point value on the top ranging from 10 to 50. The rules for the game are simple and are printed every freaking where they possibly can be. Each player has 3 slugs and they take turns firing them, starting with the slugs with the highest number until they fired all of them. You gain the points of each slug that hits the target. However, if your opponent fires a slug that overlaps yours, they gain the points of your slug instead. Simple enough, it's more of a skill game than a strategy game. Notable is that the guns don't actually use a trigger mechanism. Yeah, the triggers are just kind of painted on. Instead, one loads a slug in the front, pulls back the plunger and lets go in order to launch the slug. The blasters are also designed to work with basic darts from Nerf guns, and it makes a pretty average dart blaster. The blasters also allow additional dart storage underneath the handle. There are also some little slug figures, which are sold in pairs. They're cute and well-designed, and also have the additional feature of being able to sit on top of one of the blasters, like a sort of mascot. There are two kinds of blasters, a basic variety and a deluxe variety, which has more features and more power, but is of course more expensive. The deluxe blaster also has several hard points on the barrel and grip for accessories that might come out in the future. They also include a plastic shield as a target, which can be hung on the wall for target practice. One can also hold the shield by putting their hands in the Live Long and Prosper sign. Ha! Now that I have a blaster and a shield, I'm ready to, Wait a minute. How do I fire the gun now? Yeah, the Slugterra toys have their shortcomings. Still, credit where credit is due. The suction darts are really good at sticking, so that, even a light toss by hand will make them stick. Still, that carries with it the implication that, you might as well just throw them by hand and not bother with the dart gun, and in the case of the basic little dart guns, that's pretty much true. Also, I'm seeing in the show that the slugs are loaded into canisters which are put into the guns, rather than the breech-loading toys we get. Is that really so difficult to do in toy form? I mean, disregarding this real-working, magazine-fed, lever-action rifle by Busby Toys that uses actual plastic cartridges for only $13? I guess it would be impossible to make one for Slugterra in the $20-$25 range? I mean, if a company can put out a toy this complex for only $13, why not do something like it for Slugterra? If price is an issue, keep in mind that people are willing to pay extra for something that behaves more like it does in the TV show. The various tiers of Star Wars lightsabers, for example. Also, for how often they're printed, the rules for the game are actually sort of vague. How far do you stand from the target? After you fire your strongest slug, do you have to go in order from strongest to weakest, or can you mix it up? What if a bunch of darts cross over? The cowling also decreases the range of the darts by a whole lot and makes it difficult to load and fire properly, with creases developing in the cowling surprisingly fast. There is also no effective way to store the cowling safely. I think there are a few things that could be done to improve the game. For example, due to how much the range of the darts drop, a firing range of 10 to 12 feet would be good for a standard range. Perhaps some darts could have special abilities printed on the bottom corner, like ones that add a bonus to slugs of the same element, or slugs that allow you to shoot them twice, or stick them to the board before the game begins. Properly embracing the game's mechanics and slug variety rather than just being a glorified game of darts. So yeah, Slugterra. It's a pretty good show with a bit of a Western twist to it that I think is a lot better than a lot of the cartoons I've featured on here before. The toys, however, I think they could stand to have a little bit more fidelity to what you see in the TV show, and I think they should embrace the variety of slugs they have a bit better with the game and with the toys. If they did that, I think that would be wonderful. Anyway, Slugterra is definitely something to keep an eye out for. They're doing kind of the short season models, which means they can focus more on the quality of the episodes rather than the quantity of them, which hopefully will add up to something really good. Anyway, that was Slugterra, and this is Kohdok signing off.